Hello friends, a very good morning to all of you. I am Neha and I am back with the morning tales for today. So I have made a special blog for today, that is the news of the day blog. And what is there in this? Let us discover. So the central government is planning to set up a national genomic grid in line with the National Cancer Tissue Biobank to increase research in cancer and make treatment available to all patients. So there are three things that we need to bifurcate in this sentence. First is that a national genomic grid is going to be set up by the central government, as the central government is planning to do so. Second thing is that it is in line with the National Cancer Tissue Biobank. Basically, it will be built on the similar model of National Cancer Tissue Biobank. And third, the purpose behind setting up this national genomic grid is to increase research in cancer and to make the treatment of cancer available to all patients. Basically, the word all patients refers to the patients belonging to different categories of economy. Now, the purpose or the functionality of this national genomic grid would be to collect samples from patients to study their genomic factors, or basically the genes which are influencing cancer, and identifying the right treatment modalities for the Indian population. So basically, in order to develop a right kind of method for treating cancer which is suitable for Indian population, this national genomic grid is going to be established. Now let us discuss a little more about this National Cancer Tissue Biobank. So this NCTB is a joint initiative of Department of Science and Technology and IIT Madras. And this NCTB has a capacity to collect 50,000 genomic samples from cancer patients. So that was all about the today's blog. And now let's move on to the questions of today. So first question is, which company has launched the Good Vibes and Relumino apps for deafblind and people with low vision? So this is a quite good initiative that has been taken up by a company to help the deafblind and people with low vision. So which company is this? It is Samsung. Now Samsung has launched Good Vibes in partnership with Sense India. So Sense India is the organization which has partnered with Samsung to develop this Good Vibe app. Now through this Good Vibes, the deafblind people can easily connect with their caretakers. Now the second app, that is Relumino, has been built in association with National Association for the Blind. So these two organizations have partnered to develop Relumino application, which will help the people with low vision to interpret the images better. Next question of the day. So where is the 8th edition of Asian Ministerial Energy Roundtable being held? So this is a static question which you need to remember, as it is important from exam point of view. So this 8th Asian Ministerial Energy Roundtable is being held in Abu Dhabi in UAE, and India is being represented by Dharmendra Pradhan, who is the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Now during this roundtable, Dharmendra Pradhan has discussed about the Energy Vision of India, which was launched in the year 2016. Now this Energy Vision of India aims to provide a roadmap for India in the field of energy consumption and production. Now this Energy Vision of India is based on four pillars, and that are energy access, energy efficiency, energy sustainability, and energy security. So that was the thing which I found the most important in this news. So now let us move on to the next question. So our next question is, which country is the world's most censored country according to the report released by the Committee to Protect Journalists? So recently this organization has released a list of top 10 countries which are highly censored, or the countries which censor their press and suppress the right to seek information and right to speech, freedom, etc. So according to this report, Eritrea, which is an African nation, is the world's most censored country. And in this picture, there is the parameters and the list have been mentioned. So there are 10 parameters on which these 10 countries have been measured, and the parameters are absence of restrictions or privately owned or independent media, criminal defamation laws, blocking of websites, jamming of foreign broadcast. So these are the various methods through which a government or a sovereign tries to suppress the media power and to confiscate the right to seek information. So you can click a screenshot of this picture to remember these facts for a later stage also. Now this reminds me one more thing, that friends, if you want to attempt these quizzes, so you can do so by visiting our website. The link of the website is given below in the description box, from where you can directly go to the quiz section and attempt these quizzes on our website. So our next question for the day is, which country has become Asia's first country to release the plain cigarette packaging? So basically, this plain cigarette packaging aims to discourage the new users as well as the existing users from buying this cigarette. And recently, Thailand has become the Asia's first nation to release the plain cigarette packaging according to the guidelines of WHO. Now, I have a question for you guys. Now, can you tell me that which country is the world's first country to release the plain cigarette packaging? So friends, I will be waiting for your answers. Do mention your answers in the comment section below, that which country is the first one in the world to release plain cigarette packaging. And remember that Thailand is Asia's first country only. The next question is, where is the 22nd session of UN Committee on Convention on Rights of Persons with Disability being held? This meeting was held in Switzerland, Geneva. There is also one fact which is related to India. So during this committee's meeting, the first report which India had submitted to the United Nations Committee on this Convention on Rights of Persons with Disability was discussed. So India had submitted its first report to the UN committee in the year 2015, and this report was on the status of people with disability living in India. So apart from this, I have a question for you now, that do you guys know that in India we have an act that is named as Rights of Person with Disability, and this right or this act aims to ensure the equitable distribution of resources to the persons with disability, as well as to ensure that the persons with disability get a dignified life. So now my question for you is that when was this act launched, or when was this act enacted? So that is my question for you today, and do not forget to mention your answers in the comment section below. And friends, if you are liking our morning tales, so do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. And also, I am reminding you that you can attempt these quizzes by going to our website, and the link of the website has been given below. Now the next question for today is, who among the following has become the youngest governor in India? So let me first tell you that what is an average age of the governors in India. So in India, there is 73 years age benchmark, which is considered as the average age for governors. Now this woman, whose name is Tamilisai Sundaranjan, has become India's youngest woman, or India's youngest governor of either gender, and she is at present 58 years old. Now at present, she is the only person below 60 years of age who is a governor of a state. Now an important question arises here, that she is the governor of which state? So she has been appointed as the governor of Telangana, and she is also the second governor of this state. Now since the state is the very new state and it was formed in the year 2014, so that is why she has been appointed as the second governor of Telangana. Now my question for you is that, who is the first governor of Telangana? That you have to mention in the comment section below. Now apart from this, from the options which I have mentioned here, there is one name that I want to discuss about. So the name is Bishwa Bhushan Harichand. So he is the oldest governor at present and his age is 85 years. And now friends, it's time to discuss one committee. So which committee I have in store for you? So this is the Committee on Currency Movement. In the recent months, this Committee on Currency Movement had also suggested measures such as the grouting of ATMs in order to increase their security, as well as the currency chest. So we have already discussed both the recommendations in one of our previous morning tales. That is why I am not taking up those topics again here. Now let us discuss about this committee itself. So this committee is headed by D.K. Mohanty and it was formed in the year 2016 by RBI. And as the name itself suggests, that the committee provide recommendations on the movement of currency in India. So that was all about this committee. And now let's move on to the next question of the day, that is, World Bank is the outcome of which of the following conference? So a quite interesting as well as important question it is. So we have five conferences here: Rotterdam Conference, Bretton Woods Conference, Potsdam Conference, Yalta Conference and Basel Convention. So out of these five, it is Bretton Woods Conference which is the parent conference out of which this World Bank sprung up. So World Bank and IMF, that is International Monetary Fund, are together called the Bretton Woods Twins. So it is evident that IMF was also created in this Bretton Woods Conference itself. Now friends, this picture is of the World Bank Group. So World Bank is not an individual organization, it is a group of five organizations. So first organization is International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, International Development Association, International Finance Corporation, Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency and International Center for Settlement of Investment Disputes. So these are the five organizations which make up the World Bank Group, and these two organizations together are called World Bank. So these two make up the World Bank. Now I have one question for you. When was this Bretton Woods conference held? Now the last question of the day is, how many countries are members of World Meteorological Organization? So we have already taken up questions related to World Meteorological Organization, such as its headquarters and its president. So now I have taken up one more question from this organization itself, and that is members. So the members of this organization are 187 with 6 member territories, and these 6 member territories are divided into 6 regions, and those 6 regions are Africa, Asia, South America, North America, Central America and the Caribbean, and Southwest Pacific as well as Europe. So these are the 6 regions in which this 6 member territories is divided. So now friends, it's time to conclude our morning tales for today, and I hope that you have liked our video. So friends, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you so much.